prepare to meet the widow like never before. Hey guys, what's up, it's Sam. Hope you had a great Easter weekend. Hope you got out there, enjoyed the sun, made the most of those 4 days off, and you know, really had a good time to relax. 2020 was a really hard year, and I think we all needed a good break over Easter. And of course, one of the films that was affected last year was Marvel Studios' Black Widow. Of course, it didn't make it into theaters last year, but it is now going to arrive in theaters this year. It is a film to celebrate. This is going to be one of the biggest blockbusters of the year. And of course, we've got a very special surprise over Easter in the form of the final trailer for Black Widow. I have it in front of me. I really want to check this one out. I think this is going to be awesome. Here goes. Here is Black Widow, the final trailer. Let's get into it. Here we go.
You don't know everything about me. I've lived a lot of lives before I was an Avenger.
Oh, right back to the beginning.
Before I got this family. I made mistakes choosing between what the world wants you to be. And who you are.
Oh yeah.
We have to go back to where it all started.
Young Natasha.
Where did you think I was all this time?
We have unfinished business.
My girls.
Oh, young Alexi.
I'm sorry. We had our orders and we played our roles.
It wasn't real.
It was real to me. To me, you were everything.
Oh, Taskmasker. Oh, this is going to be awesome. Oh!
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
One thing's for sure. I'm done running from my past.
Yes. Oh, yeah, there we go. Black Widow. Plus. Oh yeah. So guys, there you go. Black Widow, the full and final trailer. How awesome was that? Director Cate Shortland has done an amazing job there. Absolutely loving this. So let's get in there and break down this trailer. So obviously, this is the final trailer, and while we've seen a lot of action in previous trailers and a lot of character and story, this trailer, this is about legacy, and legacy in Black Widow is about family. So obviously we're introduced to her wider family of Yelena, her sister, played by Florence Pugh, Alexi, aka the Red Guardian, played by David Harbour, who's basically her father figure, and Melina, played by Rachel Weisz, who's also a Black Widow, and is kind of the mother figure to Natasha. And obviously this is a story about a ragtag family going up against the Red Room, going up against the forces of Taskmaster, an invincible bad guy from the MCU who can basically copy any combat skill of any person he fights and use it as against them. And that is a real opponent that Natasha's going to have to go for it to defeat. And this is just promising, you know, one of the blockbuster events of the year. Black Widow just looking stunning. Absolutely love this trailer. But of course, we got to break down this trailer. So getting into it further, obviously, Cate Shortland has done a fantastic job finding a great balance between the high concept action, you know, special forces action of the MCU that we've, you know, seen recently in The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Absolutely loving that series, by the way. Got a full review up now for the latest episode on SpicyPulp. So make sure you check that out. The Power Broker just threw on fabulously there. But back to Black Widow, along with the likes of The Bourne Identity, it's that real high concept spy thriller action, you know, that real modern edge that we've become accustomed to. Cate Shortland has done an amazing job of capturing that here, and she's married that together with a intimate family drama, basically a family drama of a ragtag family who come back together one last time to fight the good fight and save the world. And you know, it's working. This trailer just looks fantastic. One thing that I was really surprised by this trailer is we get a look at a young Natasha. You know, obviously this image here of a young Natasha. She is, you know, obviously in the late 80s, early 90s, going through that grunge phase. She's got the punk rock blue hair. You know, she's obviously a bit of a tomboy, a bit of a grungy kid. And then, you know, she's thrown into the Red Room and the Widow program and becomes this highly efficient assassin. And, you know, we all know what happens next. You know, joining up with the Avengers, meeting up with Hawkeye, all that kind of stuff. But we're going to see her origins here. And I think that's really significant because, obviously, Black Widow, you know, she was the one who started it all for the Marvel Cinematic Universe, you know, making her first appearance in Iron Man 2, then going on to the Avengers and all those subsequent films, and obviously Avengers Endgame, where she made the ultimate sacrifice to save the world, you know. So Natasha Romanoff, played by Scarlett Johansson, has been, you know, she was the trendsetter, she was the starter for all of the Marvel films, and when it comes to female heroes. And, you know, now of course we've got Captain Marvel and Valkyrie and, you know, the Scarlet Witch, but it all began with Black Widow. And there is a helicopter. Which is also, I guess, in keeping with Black Widow, because there's some serious action. I think that's now gone over. Yeah, cool. So the helicopter's gone. So Black Widow, driving black into Black Widow. So again, we've just got a ton of action here mixed with that family drama. And I'm really loving it. I love that we get to see, you know, young Natasha along with young, you know, Alexei, and even, you know, a quick snap of young Milena, who I think, you know, Rachel Weisz's character, you know, she's got a debt to pay. It looks like she sort of pushed Natasha into the Widow program, you know, and maybe, you know, wasn't always, you know, a good maternal figure, and so obviously she's got a debt she has to pay. Obviously Alexei, played by David Harbour, you know, we've got young Alexei when he's this handsome young Russian, and then we see him a bit later when he's become a bit too familiar with the vodka bottle, and you know, obviously he's got something to make up, you know, he's been this, you know, absentee father, he's got something to prove. So obviously it's a story about a family coming together to do the right thing and save the world, mixed in together some great spy action, and I think we're gonna have a really fun film there. Cate Shortland has just done a fantastic job, and I'm really excited to see what happens next with this film. But yeah, so far looking great. I also have to jump in and say that Taskmaster, just seeing Taskmaster on the screen is awesome. Obviously this is a character who is one of the most formidable villains in the MCU. Basically has the ability to copy any combative that he fights, so any combat move you throw at him, he'll memorize it and use it against you with a twist. And so I think for a character like Black Widow, who is, you know, so agile and, you know, also has that kind of cat-like, you know, agility, you know, has that mix of, you know, sort of capoeira meets Krav Maga makes, you know, BJJ, you know, obviously she's got those fighting skills, and to see those used against her, I think is going to be very interesting. You know, obviously she's got her famous, you know, grappling technique where she springs up and spins around her, you know, her target and incapacitates them that way, but I don't think that's going to work yet. And I think this is going to make the combat really innovative, and I can't wait to see what Shortland does here with that combat. Speaking of combat, of course, the final part of the trailer with the mid-aerial battle, just insane on every single level. We've got helicopters exploding. I think there's possibly going to be some Russian version of the helicarrier. It looks like it's set over Siberia, but stuff's exploding. It's a mad fight through the air with, you know, Black Widow going up against Taskmaster and fighting on what appears to be some kind of exploding building or some exploding helicopter or the debris. They're fighting on something. I don't know. It looks insane, but I cannot wait to see that on the big screen. And, this film just looks amazing, so I think we're going to have something really incredible to watch here, and I cannot wait to see it unfold. Of course, the biggest part of this trailer and the most significant thing of it is that we finally have a release date, July 8th. Really exciting. You know, this is a date we have been waiting for a long time, and what's really exciting is that we're going to see this film on the big screen. I cannot wait to see this in IMAX. You know, Black Widow on IMAX, July 8th, doesn't get much better than that. Of course, it's also going to be on Disney Plus for, you know, those areas that are still affected by COVID-19. And, you know, I think that's great. I think, you know, audiences are going to have the option to see it on the big screen or at home or do both. And I think we're all going to do both. I know I'm going to do both. But it's just really exciting to know we're going to be able to see this on the big screen, you know, and to see that this film hasn't been a victim of COVID-19. Yes, it's had to be delayed. Yes, we've had to wait for it. Yes, it's sometimes that wait has seemed long and exasperated and we've just wanted to get there. But it's here. This film is here. It has not been a victim to COVID-19. It's risen to the challenge. you know, Cate Shortland, her entire team, all the actors, all the production crew, the entire fantastic team at Marvel and Disney, I've got to say the Disney team are just fantastic on every single level. They always commit 100%, and you know, they're bringing us this amazing story, this amazing narrative, and we're gonna see it. And you know, we've gotten there, we've gotten over the hardships of COVID-19. Of course, it's still here, we are still fighting through it, but just like Black Widow, we're not going to give up, and we are going to see this film. And you know, just like she will ultimately win out in the end, so are we over COVID-19. So I just want to throw that in there, and I think that's something very significant. You know, this is a film that has faced challenges from COVID-19, and you know, we're gonna overcome them. We are gonna see this film on the biggest screen possible, and I'm really excited to see what comes next. I just love this trailer on every single level. It's just looking amazing, and I really cannot wait to July 8th. So Black Widow, July 8th, sign me up. I'm going to be there on opening night. I cannot wait to see it. And Scarlett Johansson, she just rocks it on this trailer. She's going to rock in this film, and I'm really excited to see what's next with the MCU. And I think we're in a great position going forward with Black Widow.
One thing's for sure. I'm done running from my past.
So guys, there you go, this is my full reaction for Black Widow. Obviously you can tell I'm pumped for this trailer. Absolutely loved it. It just looks fantastic on every single level. This is going to be a really special film. I cannot wait to see what comes next with it. Again, just loving it on every single level. But enough from me, what do you guys think of the trailer? Please leave me a comment below. I'd love to know what you guys think of the trailer. You know, this is the final trailer, this is the legacy trailer, this is everything we love about Black Widow in this trailer. So please let me know what you love about Black Widow below. Of course, you can find out more what I think about the trailer at SpicyPulp.com. And of course, if you want to talk more, always happy to talk film, TV, and pop culture. Just head to our social media channels at SpicyPulp on Facebook and Instagram. Really easy to find. I'll leave the details below. And of course, July 8th can't come fast enough. So really excited for Black Widow. I think we're going to be in for a big treat. This is going to be one of the biggest blockbusters of the year, and we're finally going to see this on the big screen. So lots to look forward to. And of course, I'll chat to you next time.